Economies of scale are an important concept within business strategy. They can create a significant barrier to entry and are often cited as a source of competitive advantage. Economies of scale are present when a firm's per unit costs decline as the firm produces more output. Firms exhibiting economies of scale often are able to maintain a significant cost advantage over potential entrants. Economies of scale can be present at the machine level, as a larger machine can often produce output at a lower per unit cost than a smaller machine. Economies of scale can also be manifest at the plant level, where multiple efficient machines produce output at a lower average cost than one machine. Multiple machines operating in a plant can share costs like the cost of transporting inputs or the final product. Economies of scale can also be generated at the firm level. Expenses on things like advertising, research and development, and financing can benefit multiple plants within a firm, leading to lower per unit costs as output is increased in a given period. Let's explore average costs for Annie's cupcakes to illustrate in greater detail the concept of economies of scale. Economies of scale are generally considered to be a long-run concept. In the long run, all inputs are variable. In the short run, at least one input is fixed. For Annie, the hardest to vary input is the size of her manufacturing plant. It can take years to design and build a new manufacturing facility. Annie starts out with a 10,000 square foot facility, Plant A. These are the short run cost curves for Plant A. This size plant makes sense when Annie is producing Q1 cupcakes. When demand increases and she produces Q2 cupcakes, her per unit costs increase from AC1 to AC2. To produce the greater output, she can hire more workers, but in the short run, she cannot give the workers the additional space and machinery to make them as productive as they would be with a larger facility. Annie forecasts that in the future, demand is going to increase even more, and she hopes to be able to produce Q3 cupcakes. To make this possible at a lower per unit cost, she constructs a larger plant, Plant B. Now she is able to produce Q3 at a much lower per unit cost, AC3. However, when demand picks up again and she increases production out to Q4, her per unit costs once again increase as she hires more workers but is not able to expand the manufacturing facility in the short run. After new forecasts, Annie decides that she needs to produce Q5 cupcakes. To do this at a reasonable per unit cost once again require a larger plant, Plant C. With Plant C, she can produce Q5 at a per unit cost of AC5, which is much lower than she could do with Plant B. We have explored Annie's costs at three different plant sizes. There are actually an infinite number of different plant sizes that Annie could choose from, not just these three options. In the long run, all inputs can be varied. Due to the increased flexibility in the long run, per unit costs in the long run are at least as low as in the short run. The long run average cost curve shows all the possible per unit cost possibilities in the long run. The long run average cost curve illustrates economies of scale. Economies of scale exist in the range where long-run average cost is decreasing, or in other words, where per unit costs decrease as output increases. When the long-run average cost curve is increasing, there are diseconomies of scale. This is where per unit costs increase as output increases. Diseconomies of scale are caused by costs associated with increased firm size, like the cost of larger bureaucracy and the difficulties of managing a large operation. QMES is the lowest point on the long-run average cost curve. This is where the firm experiences minimum efficient scale. Minimum efficient scale is the minimum output per period a plant or firm must produce to minimize long-run average costs. Economies of scale can be a source of significant cost advantages to an incumbent firm over potential entrants or smaller firms. This is especially true when minimum efficient scale is large compared to market or industry demand. The long-run average cost curve shows per unit cost for a given firm. The demand curve drawn here is the demand for the entire industry. If Annie's the only firm in the industry, she could produce Q1 and charge a price of P. Since P is greater than average cost at Q1, economic profit is positive. Annie's positive economic profit is likely to attract the attention of potential entrants. Bobby would like to get into the cupcake business. He hopes to take half of Annie's market and produce Q2, which is half of Q1. At Q2, he incurs a cost of AC2. At the current price, this would be producing at a loss. For this reason, Bobby decides it does not make sense to enter the market. When economies of scale create a situation like this where there is only one firm in the market, the firm is called a natural monopoly. Economies of scale are often the barriers to entry that protect the profits of firms producing in the market structure we call oligopoly. An oligopoly is a market structure where a small number of firms has the large majority of market share. The commercial jet manufacturing industry is an example of this. The vast majority of commercial jets are manufactured by either Boeing or Airbus. For both companies, minimum efficient scale is large compared to market demand. Economies of scale are one of the key reasons why there are only a few manufacturers of any particular type of software. Manufacturers enjoy low per unit costs if they have very long runs of production. Economies of scale are also a key reason why there are so few automobile manufacturers worldwide. Each automobile manufacturer produces a relatively few models, but produces a large number of each model. It is through long runs of production that the auto manufacturers can drive down per unit costs. In each of these industries, if you want to start your own company and start it out relatively small, perhaps marketing to just the southwestern United States, your per unit cost would be many times higher than established manufacturers' costs. To compete successfully, you would have to figure out how to obtain long runs of production so that your per unit costs could be competitive. However, this may require you to displace another manufacturer because there is not enough demand for so many firms to be producing near minimum efficient scale.